Today, the number one ranked Florida Gators host the number six ranked Crimson Tide of Alabama. Here are the current NCAA standings based on average scores to this, the midway point in the regular season. As you see, Florida's number one, Alabama number six, and as usual, half of the teams in the top six are from this powerhouse conference in the SEC. Hi, everybody. I'm Bart Connor, and I'm very proud to be joined by two experts in the sport of gymnastics, Kathy Johnson Clarke, my fellow Olympic medalist, and renowned collegiate coach Suzanne Yoculan. Suzanne, we are in for a great battle tonight, aren't we?
Absolutely, Bart. Both of these teams are still undefeated in the SEC, and both of these teams posted their highest score of the year just last week. This Alabama team has had some growing pains, but if you talk to Coach Patterson, she says if they can get off to a big start on the first event, the uneven bars, that they will have the momentum to possibly upset the number one Gators. And how about this Gator team? Not only are they number one, but Coach Rhonda Fain says they are the best team she has ever coached. She's also said that she wants to send a message to the country that this team can not only do high-level difficulty, but that they can do it well. The question is, can Florida handle the pressure when Alabama turns up the heat?
Well, talk about handling the pressure. Last year, Ajahnay Dickerson, just a freshman from Florida, she was cool throughout the year. Now this year, she's supported by a couple of incoming freshmen that are also remarkable. Can Florida have their best team ever in their performance tonight?
They have two very dynamic freshmen, both former national team members doing high-level gymnastics. And most impressive, they are competing like rock-solid veterans. It's really unbelievable. Elena Johnson, a very aesthetic gymnast with clean, polished lines, but deceivingly powerful and strong, which is a nice combination. And Mackenzie Coquata, outstanding gymnast, just won a silver medal as part of the U.S. national team at the World Championship, so she can definitely handle pressure. And they're easing her into the lineup after working out some injury problems. You think about Alabama, they also have two very strong freshman all-arounders, but in terms of big, consistent scores, their leadership comes from their upperclassmen. Jerilyn Stack-Eaton, a junior and an All-American, coming off a great sophomore year, is building on that, and Kayla Hoffman having a tremendous season, had a career-high all-around score in her last competition, so she wants to keep that tide rolling.
Fantastic. Well, we're in for some great gymnastics tonight. It's the SEC at its best. Don't go away, folks. It's going to be great. Here is the format in women's collegiate gymnastics competition. There'll be four rotations, four events, vault, bars, beam, and floor. Six gymnasts for each team on each event. Just the top five count towards the team scores. First up for the Gators on vault is the junior Nicole Ellis.
Bart, this is a really strong event for Florida. They've got some very dynamic vaulters. All of them are performing. Yurchenko laid out with a full twist except for their final vaulter. They'll do a one and a half twist.
Florida ranked number one in the country on this event and two others as well.
Looking for a stuck landing to start it off. Whoa, almost got it. Just a slight hesitation on that landing. Judges are really looking for this push off the horse. You want to see height, you want to see distance, and no hop.
Good start for the Gators. Very high and clean ball. Rachel Terry now, the first bars performer for the visiting Crimson Tide, the 4'10" dynamo.
And Suzanne, we talked about this before the meet. This is a critical event for Alabama, this uneven bar rotation, if they can get through it.
It absolutely is, because they've had a low score of a 47 on this event and a high score of mid-49.
So all over the net. Oh no. And that's exactly the kind of thing you don't want to have to start with.
Especially in an away meet.
Immediately the pressure is on. Unfortunately, she over-rotated this dismount, really pulled those legs all the way through and sat it down.
Here's Miranda Smith.
Great story with Miranda Smith. Wow, look at that. Now that is the kind of thing that will rally the troops. They will really shoot up from this point on in terms of momentum, enthusiasm, excitement. They're going to go after those landings now.
There's a young lady that was granted a sixth year. It's pretty rare, in fact. She started her career at UCLA, then went to a junior college, and then she's now competing here in her last year at Florida. And boy, is she loving it. Back to the bars. Now, this is where we really talk about the critical value of lineup and lineup choices. Becca Alexson will be next up. She is the sophomore from Cordova, Tennessee, a very clean and fluid line performer on bike.
This is where every single tenth of a point matters now.
Coach Patterson said earlier that if a gymnast falls, she usually doesn't say anything to them.
Terry, and that's what we were waiting at. Waiting to report Rachel Terry's score.
Okay. Oh, that's interesting.
All right, now her score is up 9-2-7-5. I kept wondering, where is that score? How come it hasn't been reported? And so perhaps she didn't get the green light to get ready to start her routine.
I have never seen this before in collegiate gymnastics, but you can see the head judge there saying stop, stop, stop. I think the athlete saw a nod, but she never got that green flag. The judge never put up her hand for the athlete to start.
Typically, the gymnast must wait for the judges to salute them and acknowledge that all the judges are ready to start scoring the routine. By the way, back over on vault, Miranda Smith's score was a 9-9-5 to follow up Nicole Ellis's 9-8-2-5.
And what really punctuated this vault, obviously, is that fantastic landing.
She knew she had it. I loved her straight body when she contacted the floor. Very little pike in the landing. That's what made it so beautiful.
Now, it's pretty rare that something like this happens, but the gymnasts like to move this along. As soon as one team nails a vault, the next team wants to start and kind of quiet the crowd and take them out of it, especially in an away meet. So she will get another chance to start her routine. But that's not what Alabama wants in their first rotation. Remember, 9-2-7-5 to score for Rachel Terry. Six gymnasts will compete, just the top five towards the team total. Her high score for the season, a 9-8-5. Talking to Sarah Patterson, so she says, like, Becca Alexson is like Nastia Lukin with a long, lean line. And, of course, Nastia Lukin, the reigning Olympic champion in the United States.
Well, since they have that fall, obviously they can drop that low score, but every tenth of a point matters at this point. They obviously cannot afford another major break or fall, but not even tiny tenths of a point when you're competing against the best team in the country. Solid routine, but not spectacular in terms of level of difficulty.
Back over to the vault. This is that one of those sensational freshmen, Mackenzie Cacquato, just came off a silver medal at the World Championship with the U.S. team. She's known as Wacko Macko, or Macko for short. Boy, is she powerful.
Watch this vault. She can actually do a double twist on this vault. But she's wadding down to the fall to try to nail this landing.
There's her mom, Lynn Cacquato. Naperville, Illinois is where they come from. She joined the team at the semester break, so she is fresh. Ashley Sledge now for Alabama on the bars after that hiccup. The score for Becca Alexson, a 9-8-5, so much better. 9-8 average for Becca Alexson. For Becca Alexson. They did take a half a point off for going early, so they deducted from her 9-8 total a half a point. So Alabama will have to count a mistake on bars, critical error here early in the competition.
Very nice job here hitting the handstand position. Oh, short on that one. This team is a little bit rattled at this point in the competition. Was that a gorgeous double layout or what? Beautiful.
She's landing on a repaired Achilles tendon. How about that for Ashley Sledge? We'll be back with more of this exciting first rotation. Don't go away, folks. Mackenzie Cacquato had a 9-8-5. Now Ajahnay Dickerson, the sophomore, who electrified this team last year. Let's see if she can do it again.
Extremely competitive gymnast. She really focuses in and gets those landings. Does not give up.
She's the SEC Freshman of the Year last year, and she dreamed of being a Gator her whole life. Grew up in Jacksonville, Florida. She's living the dream now.
Absolutely.
Back to bars. Now, Suzanne, this is an interesting challenge for Alabama. They didn't expect to be in the hole. You said this was the event that was going to be critical for them to start off well on.
And, you know, it is a coach's nightmare for the first athlete to actually fall and then to have that problem with the Lexan. It's a big hole to climb out of, but that great routine from Sledge will get that momentum back for them.
9.825 was the score for Ashley Sledge, so they're back on track.
Gorgeous pirouette. Nice combination. Anytime you see the back-to-back, a pirouette move into a release move like that, that's bonus points. Huge dismount.
Oh, my goodness. Now Sarah Patterson told us, and so did Brian Rashilla, the assistant coach. You see him there. She said that is one of the biggest reverse hex in the world.
When you have them like that, others should have a deduction. That was enormous.
Jordan Moore, freshman, outstanding freshman. Now, Elena Johnson, the outstanding freshman for the Gators now. Score for Dickerson was a 9.875.
I love this in the warm-ups. It's a little bit bigger action in the warm-ups, but a tremendous talent. Nice form in the air.
Well, that freshman phenom off to an incredible meet again today. Boy, she is a breath of fresh air for the Gators. Back to Kayla Hoffman, the senior and one of the rocks. Sarah Patterson told us before the competition that really she has really strong routines and anchors at the end of the lineup in people like Kayla Hoffman and Geraldine Stackey. Score for Moore was a 9.775. That's her career high.
Exquisite toe point. Very nice ground throughout the season. Nice handstand. Well, they're into double layoffs. They do them well. Strong finish.
This is a tremendous amount of pressure for Alabama right now.
As a coach, what do you tell your team at this point?
You know, you don't say too much because everybody knows what happened. I mean, Florida knows too, and that's the unfortunate part because it really releases that valve for Florida and gives them, you know, an opportunity to compete without pressure.
Here's Marissa King now. This is a big ball.
This is a huge one.
The hardest vault in the competition.
Could be the highlight of the meet. That is such a difficult vault. I cannot tell you how hard it is. You have to work throughout the entire vault, and to come up with that landing, she did not budge.
And look at this. I mean, how she has no bent legs at all, which you rarely see on a 1.5.
The 2008 Olympian and four-time All-American lit up the crowd with that.
She didn't even bend her legs on the landing.
One of the same, happy with their effort in the first rotation for Florida. By the way, Elena Johnson's score was a 9.875. We'll get Marissa King's score when we come back. And now to the bars, Geraldine Stack. Kayla Hoffman's score was...
This is just... Unfortunate.
She let go too. She did not get her hands up over that bar.
Her teammate Kayla Hoffman had a 9.875, but as we've noted, two low scores already for Alabama. This score will be low as well, which means they're going to have to count two falls, which was
over a point,
not expected, and certainly a big hole that Alabama is putting themselves in at this first of four rotations.
You know, it's really unfortunate because Sarah Patterson still can't figure out why the athlete had that deduction in that routine earlier for not having the signal.
Mm. Okay, not what Alabama wanted in the first of four rotations. Sarah and David Patterson get this team together and try to regroup, see if they can recover on ball.
All right, that's not the start we wanted, but we will battle back, okay? Come on, let's show this crowd what we are made of, okay?
We'll be back with the scores from the first of four rotations. Don't go away, folks.
ESPN.
And welcome back to Gainesville. Here are the scores after the first of four rotations. A bizarre first rotation. First of all, Florida had the season high in the vault, 49-475, to lead by 1.4 over visiting Alabama. Alabama had a disaster on the bar, including two falls, and this false start by Becca Alexson. She started her routine before she got the official signal from the judges, which resulted in a half a point deduction. Suzanne, have you ever seen anything like it?
I have never seen this before in collegiate gymnastics, but you can see the head judge there saying stop. Stop, stop, stop. I think the athlete saw a nod, but she never got that green flag.
So the challenge now for Sarah Patterson is to regroup her team, move on to the vault. And that brings up a young freshman, Kim Jacob, out of Raleigh, North Carolina.
This is actually a good event for them to go to after that mishap on the uneven bars. Try to regroup here. Go after these landings hard.
It is true, Alabama ranked second in the country on this event. First up for Florida on bars is Nicole Ellis. You can see she's having a great day so far. She's coming off of two surgeries, a hip surgery, and then last year the Tommy John's elbow surgery.
On that release move, you can see a feet flex, slight leg separation here and there. Those are tiny deductions. They do add up. Another double layout dismount. That is the dismount of the competition.
Her career high, 9.8. We could be seeing a bigger score than that today. Sarah DeMeo will be next up. Kim Jacob, a 9.725.
And this young freshman has been so important to this team. She's come up with some huge scores already as a freshman. Nice landing. Doesn't quite have the amplitude that we saw from some of the Florida gymnasts on this ball.
You're not seeing that pop off that table.
Once again, the story here is all about the youth. That is an impressive performance and a mature performance from a young freshman. They seem to be pacing these two fine teams.
On bars for your Florida Gators, Andre.
Nicole Ellis had a 9.775 there, leadoff performer. Suzanne Dickerson, two-time All-American. She's a very focused young lady, and boy, she has some big moves in this routine.
Bart, you can see as she closes her eyes before she goes, imagines these skills over and over. She has big skills, but still a tiny bit sloppy on some of the positions, but she's really working hard on trying to get straighter legs, toes pointed, those little details. Listen to this crowd.
And that smile just lights up the O-Dome.
But look at the elbows on the release move. She caught with bent arms. But on the double layout, she makes up for that small deduction on the release.
Back to vault now. Ashley Sledge. Score for Sarah DeMeo was a 9.8.
So far, Alabama's building back their momentum. Going after these landings. This could be a big one. Beautiful position in the air, very stretched. Unfortunately gave up a deduction on the landing.
Ashley Sledge 2 years ago had an Achilles surgery. She's known as the class clown of this team, the Crimson Tide, but she did a good job there. Back to the bars. Dickerson in 9.875. So even though she stuck the landings, the judges did take off some deductions for some of the minor form grades.
This is a gymnast with polish, with shine. Beautiful extension of the legs. Nice job of hitting these handstands. Disco double foot. Wow, is she close to that bar? She did it in warm-ups, and I remember jumping.
She's been working on that landing. The two-time All-American pulled it in a little bit close. We'll be back for her score and more for Flotation 2 right after this. And we're back in Gainesville, Alabama on the ball. Jordan Stackey.
Oh, wow.
Decent vault in the air, but unfortunately, that's just something the judge is going to hammer you for, that long jump.
The longer it is, the bigger the deduction.
And here's a young lady who's ranked second in the all-around this year, not having a great day. 9.3 on the bars and not the kind of vault that she wanted. Her teammate Ashley Sledge, by the way, over there, had a 9.825. Score for Goodwin was a 9.825 as well, so good scores for Florida so far.
Oh, nice stall to work. So nice when you see a different element that not everyone in the competition is doing. Solid routine. I like the stall to work at the beginning. A little loose throughout the body.
Action is fast and furious in these first two rotations. Back to the vault now. Kayla Hoffman, see her scores on the bars in the first rotation.
And honestly, they need a big one here.
Stack Eaton had a 9.825.
And there it is. Oh, wow. That is a gorgeous vault in the air.
Absolutely. That was one of the best vaults of the competition. And, you know, Alabama really needs these last two gymnasts to hit a big one to get that momentum back before they rotate to the next event.
Kenji Picquato, you see her effort there in the vault in the first rotation. Malish had a 9.85 back over there on vault. Kenji Picquato now.
Kenji very, very strong on this event. She led off to the United States in the team finals at the World Championships on this event.
Coaching club gymnastics by two legendary coaches, Wu Jiani and Li Weizhu in Illinois.
Back from our day, Bart. Beautiful. Nice difficulty on that dismount. Florida has really done a fantastic job here. And the neat thing for Coach Vaughn to fame, she can see the little things that she can fix to get even better.
She said she fell in love with gymnastics watching the 96 Olympics. Well, she's living the dream here now, isn't she? Talk about freshman phenoms. Here is Deandra Milliner.
And Suzanne, I don't know what you think, but I feel like the scores are a little all over the place on vault. They just...
I haven't really figured out exactly what they're looking for.
I agree. I thought Hoffman's score was going to be higher.
Absolutely. Look, 1.5 twist here, but even Marissa King, who did the hardest vault in the competition, nailed it. Went 9.925, which is huge, but we've seen a 9.95 from her.
But you're looking for that rise off the table, and Marissa King, because of the type of vault she was doing, had to turn a little bit earlier to get that 1.5 around.
But that's the nature of the vault, and right, that's the unfortunate thing in the scoring.
9.925 9 the score for Mackenzie Cuquado. So the lowest score for Florida on the bars of 9.775. And here is another freshman phenom that could cap it all off.
Just put off her timing. For the reverse hatchet, she's just unfortunately way.
She came off that bar to do the release too late, and Florida still has 5 good scores in the back, though, so they're in good shape.
Disappointment for her, of course. National team member of the U.S. team for the last couple of years. She's had a perfect season so far. I think that's her first mistake of the year.
And this is an absolutely gorgeous event for her. And this is one of those things where you just have to get past it.
This competition is full of oddities, and it's just the emotion of Florida versus Alabama.
That's a big part of this.
It is.
Look at the beautiful lines in the handstand. Gotta love that. Seeing a lot of double layouts here. This is, this is the dismount of a competition.
And that look, the technique, is really that elite style that Rhonda Fain's been talking about. The score for her teammate, Cuquado, was a 9.9. We'll be back with the scores at the halfway point in this unusual competition right after this. Don't go away, folks. Florida's in the lead. Scores at the halfway point of this competition. Florida with a lead of 1.425 over visiting Alabama. A bizarre start to this competition that no one expected. Let's go down to Suzanne. She's with Sarah Patterson.
Coach Patterson, my heart goes out to you. What a difficult way to start a competition. What did you say to the athletes when they rotated?
You know, I just said this is a challenge. Now we have to dig ourselves out of a hole. And, you know, this could be the night when you're trying to advance at the Super 6. So, obviously, to be 1.4 down is difficult. But you know what? It's all about growing and maturing as a team. This is a young team. We learned a lot from this tonight. And we're going to come back.
Well, good luck for the rest of the competition.
Thank you.
We have to remind ourselves, this is still early in the season. So, there's still fine-tuning their routines and also getting used to competing under pressure in their place in the lineup. A lot of different factors.
First up for Florida on the beam will be Elizabeth Malice. Florida will be on beam, Alabama on floor in this rotation. The third of 4.
Some of the things the judges are watching for, they must do this acrobatic combination. They're looking for a jump with a complete split in the air. Of course, perfect balance, no breaks at all.
Interesting role for her. She stepped up to do beam for this team when Liz Green, one of their outstanding performers on the beam, stepped out of the lineup because Liz Green is dealing with a stress fracture in her back. She's going to be okay for the end of the season.
Good, solid start.
Now it's doing her part for the Gators. First up on floor for Alabama will be Rachel Terry. Saw her on the bar. She had a fall, only 9.275. Let's see if she can recover here.
Most coaches, when they're trying to do their lineup, they try to put their most consistent athlete first, and then from there they try to build their scores. You never want to put the tumbler that goes the highest early in the lineup.
position on the landing. That'll be a deduction. We'll see bigger levels of difficulty later in the competition.
Andy Stagberg now out of Chesapeake, Virginia. The sophomore takes to the beam. Elizabeth Malish had a 9.825 in their leadoff performance. Her teammate, by the way, Rachel Carey, had a 9.8 to start him off.
And that is an unusual dismount, but because it's in combination, it looks great.
Well, but this song, rather popular when they're at home, not quite so popular down here in Gainesville.
It's a great song, even
home,
in
Alabama. Elizabeth Malik.
Nice difficulty, full twisting double back.
Had a 9.825 on beam for Florida. Rachel Terry, a 9.8.
I'm looking at this difficulty from Jacob as a freshman, and wow, second in the lineup and doing this kind of stuff already. This is a great event for Alabama.
In pike position, one of the more difficult passes you'll see in collegiate gymnastics.
Once again, great work from a freshman to the beam now. Score for Randy Stagberg, 9.8. Here is freshman Alina Johnson.
What'll be interesting here is to see if she can put that fall behind her. Rhonda Payne said that she's worked a lot with her athletes this year mentally so that they are not distracted by mistakes and they can put them behind them.
Kim Jacob had a 9.85, so good scholar scores for Alabama, 9.8 and 9.85. Ashley Sledge will be up next. Talk to her before the competition about her advice to the new members of Alabama's team. They have 8 freshmen.
Your only advice best I can give them. It's not really about gymnastics. They know how to do their skills. They know what to do to hit their routines. It's just about staying calm and staying with the team and leaving the outside stuff at home and just really being prepared to get down in Florida.
This is the first time in 2 years she's competed Floretricize after an Achilles injury. It's hard not to cringe a little when they tumble when you know they've had that injury.
Back over on the beam for Elena Johnson was a 9.825.
Good to see her throw the difficulty at the end. Pike double back, but she said, Suzanne, those low landings with the chest down in the introduction.
At least she's doing it, and I have to give her kudos for that.
All right, more gymnastics coming up in the third rotation. Don't go away, folks. In Gainesville, Bart Connor, along with Kathy Johnson Clarke and Suzanne Yoculan. Marissa King coming up now on the beam for Florida. Elena Johnson's 9.825, by the way, was a career best in her very short career.
Difficult skill on beam.
How many times have you seen that one?
Not often. She is one of the strongest, most powerful gymnasts in the competition. That's what it takes to do a skill like that.
This is the same beam lineup that Florida has had for the last three competitions. So they are getting very comfortable in their position in the lineup. They've got a rhythm, and you can see that this is a very seasoned team for this early in the year.
Rhonda Fain did tell us that she's using a little different strategy. Last year they were so focused on the NCAAs because they were hosting the NCAAs and they had a chance at winning it all. Ended up fifth in a disappointment. So this year she says we're going to just take one step at a time and work our way up to the championship season.
You see Marissa got a little bit tight there. She had a slight bobble on that pass. There's a lot of difficulty in the routine. A lot of different elements in there that you risk having a slight bobble.
I just love their poise up there as a team.
Absolutely. Double twist dismount. Wow! This skill is just so amazing. She goes like she's going to do a front aerial off of 1 foot, and then it's a front layout. Lands on 2 feet going forward. She's slightly off to the side there, but great correction. Pulled it back on.
Geraldine Stack-Eaton now for Alabama. Not having a great day for the young lady who's ranked number 2 in the country in the all-around. Alabama hopes to keep this meet close. They're going to have to hit extremely well here and hope that Florida has some troubles on beam. Thank you.
sense of belief, Suzanne, that first event for them didn't take the wind out of the sails. I don't quite see the sparkle. They're coming back and they're hitting, but there's not that shine. And
well, you know, again, this is an emotional meet. You come in here, you want the upset. You know you have to hit on the first event. It's disappointing. You have to regroup. But Coach Patterson's looking at the big picture. She knows what's down the road at the end of the year.
Mackenzie Coquado having a great day for a freshman. Marissa King before her, 9.825, ties her season high.
And this is the first time Mackenzie's going to compete in the all-around. They've been easing her into each event's lineup as the weeks have gone by. She was resting an injury after the World Championships, a sprained knee. So they really want to take care of her, get her healthy. And the last competition, they put her in balance beam. She had trained 2 weeks and went up and hit it cold.
I love the fact that Coach Fain is figuring out where these athletes can be best. So many of them need time to prepare. Some of them want to go right early in the lineup to get it out of the way. She's taking the time to figure that out. Seems like she's got it pretty nailed down already.
Her younger sister, Bridget, is on the U.S. Junior now. So we'll be seeing a few years of Coquado delivering these kind of performances.
Solid routine, the difficulty.
And the sticking of dismount. The sticking of dismount so early. Amazing.
Even though she says they're not looking down at the end result at winning nationals, which is what they did last year. They're going through the process.
Back to the floor now, Deandra Milliner. 9.825 with the score for Carolyn Stack. Nice effort.
What a great addition to Alabama's team with this gymnast. Raving double front. Gorgeous landing.
She had her legs together, too.
A freshman out of Folgers Gymnastics in Wichita, Kansas. She joined the team on December 26th.
The double Arabian was beautiful. Very rarely do you see legs together on the double Arabian.
Final performer now for Florida on the beam is Ajane Dickerson. 9.925, a career high for Mackenzie Coquado. So Florida already has 5 outstanding scores. This one could cap them all.
That is uncharacteristic. She is usually just so rock solid on these landings.
We were so impressed with her last year at the SECs. Under enormous pressure, she seems so cool.
Ice water in the veins.
I saw her shake her head a little bit when she landed that. She's already disappointed with herself.
The first thing she does, even after it's a competition, is she has nailed everything. Scored high, comes back to the gym. What can I do better? What can I do better? Making me turn away from this.
She is a coach's dream. I observed earlier during the march out when the team was watching the national anthem, no one was jittering or fidgeting. They are very, very calm and focused.
Dismount. Well, she didn't nail the routine, but she also didn't give it up completely. She fought for the landing. She was a little bit off. Those things happen. It's a long season.
You know, this is a lesson an athlete needs to learn. You don't know when your score is going to have to count. So you have to fight for every little tense. And she does that right there on that flip-flop layout.
Final performance on the floor now. Kayla Hoffman, Deandra Milliner, a career-high 9-9 before her.
She stayed inbounds, but unfortunately that's a big deduction. The stumble on the landing.
She took about 3 steps on that landing, so it is a big deduction. But she saved the 110 by not going out of bounds.
Pleased with this routine, but you can see through to the beauty. The choreography is just really exquisite.
All right, that's the end of the third of four rotations. We'll update the scores when we get back. Florida in the lead. For the final rotation, you can see the team scores. Florida 1.45 ahead of visiting Alabama. And all of that lead came in that bizarre first rotation with Florida on the vault and Alabama struggling on the bars. Randy Stageberg will be up on the floor. You see her score on beam, 9-8. The sophomore out of Chesapeake, Virginia. First time this year, full invite.
That explains a huge smile.
Rhonda had said earlier that she wanted to really work on execution this year. She wanted her team to do the high-level skills, but she wants them to execute them well.
Choreography for everybody this year except for Randy. That routine worked so well last year, she went with it.
Finishing with a pike double back. Good difficulty. She's so excited, nailed every single landing.
After that big full end, she did a great, powerful final tumbling run. Deandra Milliner now. We saw her highlight on the floor. Before her, Kim Jacob had a 9.85 to lead off, and she tied her career high.
This is where a coach, Suzanne, is really watching how the freshmen perform. Under this kind of pressure, they had a disastrous first rotation.
You know, they did, and it's just, in a situation like this, when you're behind by this much, a coach has to try to look for something and encourage the team to fight back. but it is very difficult because Alabama is not under the same kind of pressure right now that they typically would be under in a big meet, and you want your athletes to face that pressure on the balance beam as many times as possible.
Interesting coaching perspective from you, Suzanne Yoculan. You, of course, won 10 NCAA team titles with your team at Georgia. So you really understand the coach's mindset at this point in the season, don't you?
I'm sure right now Coach Patterson has still a little bit of sickness in the stomach, but it's because you have your expectations set so high. And, you know, you say the right things, but it's hard to feel it.
Here is Sarah Patterson. To the floor now. Miranda Smith had a 9.95 on vault.
Early in the rotation, too.
I love that pike pull in because her legs work together. That's that execution that Miranda was talking about.
Personality
really shines through on this exercise. There's a new combination for her. She said she had shoulder surgery in April 2009, so she had to adjust her routine because the combination pass she was using hurt her shoulder. That one was very nice. They travel here from California for every meet cross country, and the sixth year redshirt senior having a great night. Back to the beam now, Marissa Gutierrez, and at Houston, the sophomore for Alabama. The end of Mooner scored 9.75 before her.
This athlete is a sophomore. She did not have as many competitive opportunities last year because Alabama had four All-Americans as seniors that actually graduated. So it's not just the freshmen that are inexperienced, it's some of the upperclassmen that are inexperienced as well.
Really is what collegiate gymnastics is all about, though, being able to step into a situation, be ready to compete on an event, but perhaps your backup in,
yes,
you've got to be ready to do it.
And I love that about college gymnastics. Elite gymnastics is all about the individual. College gymnastics is all about that team chemistry.
What can I do to help the team? How do I design a routine and perform a routine that will best help the team?
Sierra is known to be stable on beam and steady and consistent. That's what you need in the middle of the lineup. Back to the floor now. The score for Miranda Smith was a 9.925, tied her career high. You see the scores there for the freshman phenom, Mackenzie Cacquado. What's she going to do here?
She's having a great competition. She is so powerful.
This is interesting because last week we were at Georgia against Auburn. Lindsay Cheek from Georgia, the freshman, just had a career day. That's what we're seeing here as well.
It's amazing to me how Florida has so many athletes that are just this good in the all-around on the same team in the same year.
We're back in Gainesville. Kayla Hoffman, you see her scores for the day, a disappointment on the floor.
This is an event Kayla can shine. Her elegance, her form, can truly be highlighted here. Beautiful flexibility. She really shows that full split on those jumps. I love her footwork.
Before the break, the score for her teammate Gutierrez was a 9-8.
Oh. I had a weird feeling before she even went for the skill. Just did not look confident.
You know, there's so many meets that are pivotal for a team, and this could be one of those ones for Alabama. Last year at the national championships for Florida, finishing a disappointing fifth, that was pivotal to them in terms of what they're doing this year.
Nice. Got her fight back.
Interesting coach, Sarah Patterson, down at the end of the beam in the sight line of the athlete. Suzanne, did you do that when you were coaching?
I was too nervous to stand still. But Sarah actually has stood in that position for about the last 20 years.
Do you think the gymnasts take comfort knowing that she's down there?
I think it is a sight thing for them, that they're used to looking at her during practice. She stands there as well. But, no, I couldn't do that.
Well, the freshmen have been lighting it up today. Not so for the upperclassmen. Mackenzie Cacuado, career high 9-9. She had a banner day. Elena Johnson, let's see how she can finish up. Talk about outstanding freshman. See, she landed on that sting mat. The gymnasts are allowed to use those sting mats to protect their ankles and heels on the landings in competitions like this. To the beam now. Kayla Hoffman after her fall. 1-3-7-5. Sarah DeMeo up now.
Nice eye opening now.
They're really having some trouble tonight. This event was an event that Coach Patterson was really hoping that the team would have to perform on. She's trying to figure out the lineup on this event. She's got so many athletes that can perform on balance beam. And she says that this event has not gelled for them yet.
She's been really concerned about beam. They've struggled in the first few meets, and she's really, as you mentioned, not confident with this inexperienced team. Who can step up and provide leadership there?
The only thing that gets you there is experience, though. And if it doesn't break you, it'll make you. You'll just keep plugging away. You've got to experience what it feels like under pressure, on the road, on this event.
DeMeo normally very poised. Had a 9.925 versus Penn State on the beam earlier this year. Wow. As an A. Dickerson, the beam was her low score today, otherwise a good meet. Score for Elena Johnson, 9-9.
has done so well. You see so many of them in competition, the double pike at the end of the routine. But look how high her chest is when she lands. Perfect.
Oh, they're loving it here at the O Dome. Back to the beam. Score for DeMeo, by the way, 9-7-7-5. So Gerilyn Stackman, who's had an inconsistent day today, will wrap it up for the Crimson Tide on this event. But Florida clearly in charge. And one performance away from locking this one down.
And hopefully this is just a hiccup in this process for especially these two gymnasts, the upperclassmen. These are the kind of mistakes you don't want to dwell on, though. You want to just learn from them, put it behind you, move on. Focus on the next competition and how you can get better.
Ashley Priest, one of their superstars, is not in this competition today. She has had some surgeries, and they're going to need her for the championship part of the season.
Hoping to get her back for at least balance beam. And Florida says nice landing on that dismount. A good finish.
Okay, so Gerilyn Stack-Eaton finishes strong for the Crimson Tide. But this is an encore of sorts because Florida clearly in charge. The score for Ajahnay Dickerson, a 9-9-5, tied her career high. And we're not done yet.
This is a treat. This girl can tumble.
Rhonda Fain very comfortable with the depth of talent. As she said, and we talked about at the top of the show, she doesn't want to talk about it too much, but this just might be her best team ever.
She said it was her best team ever, and it's the best team Florida's ever had that I've seen. This team already has passed the 197 mark without this score.
Oh. You see why they're ranked number one in the country on this event as well.
They did it with difficulty, with performance.
And the score for Marissa King, a 9-9-7-5 to cap it off. For the Gators, a career high for King on a spectacular night here in Gainesville. We'll be back with the final scores and we'll wrap it up after this. And welcome back. Here are the final scores from tonight's classic battle between Florida and Alabama. Florida, the only school in the nation to score over 197 this year, and they've done it in back-to-back meets. Defeat the visiting Crimson Tide of Alabama, 197.55 to 195.45. Alabama's fate was somehow sealed with this rare false start deduction incurred by Becca Alexson in the first rotation. She heard her name announced by the PA announcer. She thought she got a nod from the judge. But you see the judge waving her off. She did not get the official green flag, which is the official indication to start her routine. But the big story tonight really lies with the freshman phenoms from Florida, and a very happy Rhonda Fain and Mackenzie Cacquado are with Suzanne Yoculan.
Coach Fain, oh my gosh, you knew this was going to be a good night. You know your team is great. What else can you get out of them?
Wow, it was so exciting. We were just thrilled that everyone really came out and competed aggressively, but had fun. And, you know, Mako's first all around, she won. And I think it was, again, just a great team effort.
Three different Gators win the all around in the recent competitions. Unbelievable. You don't just have thoroughbreds, you have a Kentucky Derby.
Well, that's nice that you say that. We're really just trying to pace the athletes, and we're going to make sure that we rest our all arounders when we can and not get them too tired by the end of the season. We need to be fresh at the end. So that's what we're trying to do.
Mackenzie, your first all-around competition as a Gator, how did it feel?
It felt amazing. I mean, I came in today just focusing on one event at a time, not rushing myself through anything, and it turned out well.
It really did turn out well. Where do you go from here?
I just need to polish up my skills. I mean, I have my routines down in the sticks on vault and bars, so I think that's really important.
This team is amazing. I know that you said that you wanted to send a statement to the rest of the country that you were going to do the difficulty and do it well. Did you accomplish that tonight?
I definitely think we did. You know, we added Marissa's double layout as well. At the end, we decided just go for it, and it was gorgeous. And I'm just really happy for her. I'm happy for everybody. Still sticking to our guns about the difficulty and doing it well.
Thank you, Coach Fain. Mackenzie, back to you, Bart.
Thank you, Suzanne. What a night. Mackenzie Cacquado, her all-around of 39.575 is the best ever by a Gator, making an all-around debut. What a great night from Gainesville. Once again, our final score, 197.55 for Florida to 197.425 for Alabama. For Kathy Johnson Clarke and Suzanne Yoculan, I'm Bart Connor. So long from the University of Florida in Gainesville. For more information, log on to ESPN.com.